That sound, we all know it. It means nothing but to get up and get going with your day. But there are sounds that may just instill fear into its listener. That is the noise of the emergency alert system. That noise and system are so special, I cannot play the sound on TV, radio, or probably even the internet. Have you ever stopped to think about this system that just stays waiting quietly in the background?
Welcome to Encoded Productions. Today, we're taking a deep dive into the emergency alert system, its history, its creation, and its future. So come along. Before the emergency alert system, the U.S. had two other systems. These were CONELRAD and the Emergency Broadcasting System, or EBS. CONELRAD, the first of which came online in 1951. And before CONELRAD, the U.S. had no way to contact all of its citizens in a timely manner during a crisis. The second system, the Emergency Broadcasting System, came online in 1963 and didn't go off the air until 1997. So, let's take a quick detour and dive a little deeper into these two systems as they laid the groundwork for our more modern emergency alert system. We'll start with CONELRAD because it was the first system to come online in 1951. When CONELRAD came online, it was radio only. And when CONELRAD had to send out an alert, it used the 640 kilohertz and the 1240 kilohertz AM radio frequencies. When it did send this alert out, it used a very interesting alerting system.
This system was turning the station off for 5 seconds, returning to the air for 5 seconds, shutting the station down again for 5 seconds, then coming back on the air with a tone for 15 seconds more.
Now we'll move on to the Emergency Broadcasting System, or EBS. EBS replaced CONELRAD in 1963. It also added an on-TV component. Now, here are some of the many features that the emergency broadcasting system added to emergency alerts in the U.S. in the mid-60s.
Some of these were better integrations for national weather alerts. Also, the system eventually was replaced by the Emergency Alert System, or EAS.
Now we'll move on to the current system, the Emergency Alert System. This system replaced the Emergency Broadcasting System in 1997. But wasn't approved until 1994. Now, the emergency alert system added a lot of features to the already somewhat feature-rich emergency broadcasting system. Some of these were
even more integrations with the National Weather Service, the added ability to broadcast amber alerts, but the big upgrade was so that a message from the president could be seen or heard anywhere in the United States in 10 minutes or less.
Now, we're going to explain how the system works. It all starts at PEP stations, or primary entry point stations. This is boring. Let's spice it up a little.
Now, that's better. So, now our world is made of Legos, and let's see how the alert is sent out. So like I said earlier, messages start here at PEP stations. Then they are broadcast over radio waves to other broadcasting establishments, where EAS signals are converted into the super end-of-the-world-esque voices that you may hear. After that, the message will automatically interrupt the regular programming, and then it is broadcast and you see the alert. Well, at least for these people, it's just telling them to subscribe, so should you. Then, after the load is over, the station returns to its regularly scheduled programming. So, that's how the system works in a nutshell. Pretty simple.
Even though the emergency alert system is great, it's awesome, and usually works pretty well, there are times when it hasn't worked so well. Let's go over a few of these major incidents. One major incident happened in Hawaii when an employee accidentally pushed the emergency alert saying Hawaii was about to get nuked and it's not a drill.
It caused major panic in the state, all because of one careless worker who accidentally sent out the alert. Now, another vulnerability is its vulnerability to hackers. This is just about as bad as the accidental misuse that happened in Hawaii. Now, we do really need to fix these hacking vulnerabilities.
So, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe. Comment down below what you want to see in a future one of these weird essay explainer video things. And thanks for watching. Goodbye.